In today's video, I'll quickly show you how to remove an electric Eowheel 6 motor, since several people have been asking about that. And then I'm also going to go into a more interesting topic where I talk about a new issue I found with electric Eowheel 6s. It affects a very small number of them, and once you've broken in your electric Eowheel 6, if you're not seeing the issue, it won't show up, which is great news, but I am seeing basically a higher failure rate with motors, and we've actually tracked down what the problem is, and I'll be addressing it in the future to get reliability numbers to where they should be. But first, I want to show you how the motor on an electric Eowheel 6 is removed. So you'll have gotten a little hex wrench in your parts pack, and you will just use that with the pulley. There's a motor pulley, a metal pulley on the motor. So you'll stick the hex wrench in there. And this is also how you can make sure that this pulley is tight. Some people have had issues with it coming loose, but you just take off the metal pulley, and that makes it easier to access these two screws. So all you have to do to remove this motor is take out these two screws. And at this point, the motor will be free except for this these six wires sort of holding it in place. You can just sort of, that one came out a little easier than normal, but normally it's stuck in there like this. And what I'll do is I'll just grab the wires with one hand like this and the motor with the other hand, and you just sort of pull and wiggle a little bit and it comes off pretty easily. And then if you've gotten a replacement motor, for me, it's pretty easy to just do those reverse steps, and that's all there is to changing it. So now let me talk a little bit about the problem. What we've found is that a larger number of motors are failing within their first 5 or 10 hours of use, usually within their first hour of use, than should be failing. So with motors, it's pretty normal to see a higher rate of failure right in the very beginning, and then they last a very long time, and then they start failing at higher rates towards their end of life. So that's a typical motor failure rate curve, and the people who've made this motor for me understand how many motors should fail in the beginning. And they didn't give me that number, but it should be very, very small. And I was seeing like above 1%, which doesn't sound like a lot, but when you're shipping out, you know, over 2,000 spinning wheels, that's 20 motors, 20 plus motors. And it's not actually like sending out the replacement motor that was annoying me. It was just like, I didn't like the users who were seeing this, you know, have the experience where the motor would not function correctly. Either it would completely stop, or it would have trouble where it would only start once in a while. And we actually figured out what the problem was after I got a few of the defective motors back. And the problem is actually my fault. It's a small design issue. So I used a 5 millimeter long screw to go through the case and into the motor. And I should have used a 4 millimeter long screw. So basically, here I have another motor over here. So I've already sort of pre-taken this motor apart, so this will be easy. But yeah, you can remove the end cap. So this is not something you would normally do. I actually don't know how to do this without destroying the motor. There's a little circuit board. This controls some of the, it monitors the temperature, the speed of the motor. It also does the some of the controlling of the motor and over current, over temperature. It does a bunch of cool things. That's why there's a circuit board inside of this. And then there's a brushless, this is the brushless motor controller, or the brushless motor itself is sort of right here. You can remove the center portion. I wasn't actually able to get rid of get the coils out, but this is what you sort of see inside there. Let me see if I can focus better. There we go. So this is sort of the inside of the motor after I took all the parts out. And I would like to get these wires out, but they're glued in there pretty well, or somehow they're adhered in there, and I wasn't able to get them out reasonably. So I'm just leaving them in. But what you should know is there these coils of wire that you see here, they're also facing this way. And what's happening is on some of the motors, these screws are poking through just far enough that they're rubbing up against these metal coils, and after a while the screws wear through some of the enamel on the wires, and that's causing problems. Vast majority of motors don't have any contact here. It's just dependent on exactly, you know, how the motors were wound, and that's why I never noticed it. Like, I looked at 20 different motors when I was sort of prototyping everything, and everything was good on all 20 of those, but evidently about 1 or maybe 1.5% of the motors have wires that stick out just slightly longer, and these screws are then touching them, and you know, within, you know, half an hour, an hour of use, the motor will start acting oddly, and that's basically the problem. So I will be doing a rework on all of the ones that I'm sending out for the grounding, which I've covered in a different video. I'll actually put a link to that in the show notes, and then this issue will also be resolved. So those are the two workarounds that I know of that will be implemented in future ones that I'm shipping out, so that the electric EOWheel 6 will be even more reliable going forward. If you would like to perform a fix, I will put a link to screw in the show notes, the 4 millimeter long screw instead of the 5 millimeter. Another option is to just get, you know, any washer that will fit. So here's like a little tiny washer, and if you can fit that on, and then that washer will hold the screw out slightly longer and address the issue. But again, if you're not seeing an issue and you've already used it for a few hours, that really means it's not going to affect you. But if you're the kind of person who wants to do it anyways, that's sort of what I would do to sort of fix it locally. If you do have a problem with the motor, just contact me and I will send you a replacement motor. As I said, this is really only affecting a very tiny number of people, so it's not a big thing to worry about. Another thing worth noting that I will be changing going forward is this pulley. You ideally want like a half a millimeter to a millimeter gap, sort of like this. If it's sitting like this, there's just a little bit of extra wear on the outer housing of the motor. This is something else the motor people pointed out. So what I recommend doing is just sort of lifting it slightly up and then tightening it. You just need any amount of gap there that you can get. They recommended half a millimeter, which is just not very much. It's the thickness of a few sheets of paper. So that's all there is to that. And the last thing I'll mention in this video, just sort of a little bonus, is that I've looked into purchasing some O-rings that will work as drive belts for the electric EOWheel 6. I know a lot of people live internationally, and the shipping costs to get out there is really expensive. So I designed a really high quality drive belt for the electric EOWheel 6 that didn't slip and was just the right tension and things. And it was made out of polyurethane, which is a commonly used high quality plastic for belts. But I know that getting those belts is difficult. So I did find an O-ring, and I'll put the size of it in the show notes. It's also on the electric EOWheel 6 page as a possible replacement part. But so the standard drive belt doesn't have really any slip, and the O-rings will have a little bit more slip in them. So that's not ideal, but they definitely work. I've been testing them, and they're really affordable. So if you're looking for a lower cost replacement drive belt, that'll be a great option. It's not necessary, though, because most people won't probably ever need them. The drive belts that came with the electric EOWheel 6 will last a very long time, and there should have been two of them in your box. So my expectation is that they'll last for years and years of use, because in some of our stress testing cases, we used them for a very long time and didn't really see any appreciable wear on them. So I'm not too concerned. I just wanted to give more options to people who are looking for parts that could eventually wear out. So that's sort of what I've done with these drive belts. I sort of preemptively went out and found another option, just because I know that people don't want to get stuck without replacement parts. I know that I wouldn't like that. So for my customers, I try to give you a few different options. I have no great desire to sell a whole bunch of replacement parts or anything. That's not how I want to make my money. I just want to get out the best e-spinners to you guys and let you spin away. It's not where I'm not going to be making the money off of the drive belt. So feel perfectly free to go with the O-ring option that I give you in the show notes if you do eventually need some more drive belts. Thanks for watching.